Hello guys, and welcome if you have not seen any of my videos before, but today I am going to be starting a new series where essentially what I'm doing is I'm going to build 100 crafting benches, and I have to put one of them in each house in a city. So let's just type in a random seed here. Add bonus chest. And I will turn. Yeah, actually, I'll leave that on. And I'll do large biomes. So, ready? And we begin. So, this series is going to take a very long time. Just because of. And they're not going to be like cheap little. Like 3x3. Cubes. They're gonna be actual, like, houses. And there has to be one crafting bench per each of them. So, let us begin. Oh, I guess I forgot to turn on the texture pack. Well, let's do that now. Never mind, it's not showing up. Let's actually turn down the render distance a bit. We don't want running this slow. But there we go, that should speed it up a bit. Let's see. I just want to see if there's anything new with this update that I haven't really seen before. It's mainly just to help me out with, like, building recipes and stuff. For what I'm doing, but so there's that. Just in case you were wondering why I have too many items, but these axes are gonna help a lot. Same with that forest. And these torches. Along with some free food. No, let's hope we find a village nearby. We have some water here for growing crops if we need it. Probably an ocean over there if there's squid. Yeah, so let's start chopping down trees. I honestly don't really care about the wood that's used in the crafting bench. Just the wood that's used in the houses has to be either normal wood or spruce wood. I will not use like birch wood or jungle wood because I don't really like that. But for crafting benches and doors and chests and sticks and stuff, I don't care. The only thing good about jungle trees is if you can get enough saplings from them, you can get a ton of wood. Which you can't really do with any other tree except for oak. If you end up getting, like, a super tree. But, yeah. So. Yeah, we're pretty much just going to mine as many trees as we can until I can find a. While we're walking along, trying to find a nice place to settle. Do I have a birch something? No. Well, I won't need one. Because I can still use these in that making. But, yeah. So, we're going to. First, let me make sure I'm not on. Yeah, I'm on peaceful. I'm meant to be on normal. Well. Sure, while we're here. Let's make sure everything's done. Put the FPS on. Turn loading off. Okay. Now this should run a lot smoother at a steady FPS rate. And. Now let's try and get out of this plains biome, which may take a while. Because, as you can see. Yeah, it's gonna take a while. And we already have a chest for ourselves, so... Let's check. This is the only kind of cheating I will use from too many items. Which is to find a clock in here and look at it. Okay, yeah, so... It's still morning, and our spawn is that way, so... We should be fine. But, also, if you guys don't want me using too many items, even if it's just for, like, this, then, yeah, let me know, and I will not be using it. Yeah. You know, we should probably try and find us some more trees. Now that I think about it, that'd be pretty useful. Well, sugar cane, that'll be useful. And here's some more wood that we can use. Nice. Even though I realize we probably have walked in one nice and decently sized circle. We just need some more wood, so... I'm gonna chop down as much as I can. And this video is probably gonna be about an hour long ish. Maybe less, but. Either way, I will. Let's just try and get as much wood as we can so I can start building the crafting benches. So let's see, that means I'm going to need 400 wooden planks. Which means, you know, I'll do the math later on how much wood I'll need to build all of these, but I'll need 400 wooden planks. Well, actually, that means I will need, well, let's see, I'll need 100 pieces of wood. That was kind of stupid of me not to put two and two together, but, well. The hell? Is that zombie flame resistant? A zombie! He's not lighting on fire. Or was he just bugging out? I can't tell. Well, either way. No, he wasn't bugging out. Let's see if he starts to burn. Okay then, I want those enchanted boots. One zombie, I do realize I'm beating him with a stick. I'm going to get a sword built after I build us a wooden pick. And get us some coal and stone. Actually, after I kill him, I'll probably... Oh my god, how long is it? It's good. I'll use my axe. Jesus. He did not want to die. That was his lifelong goal, not to die. Ah, oh, that doesn't work. Oh well, let's see. Crafting bench. Like, the wood used to make tools and stuff will be birch wood. The wood used to make houses will be like this. So, this is just gonna be a quick little starter house, which probably be our permanent living quarters soon, but... You also clear out all this grass. This massive amount of annoying grass. Let's just put up a torch in here. Wooden planks. There we go. So, but we will be expanding it. It'll be taller. Well, there we go. We pretty much have our first house. We just need to build a roof. Not a fully wooden roof, but mostly wooden. We should probably build a door. That'd be a smart idea with mobs and all. Okay, we're out. Got a door. We just need to finish off the roof and we will begin some mining. Because we'll have to clear out this house, kind of. All the gravel and stone pieces of our ceiling. So let's see. Pickaxe. Pickaxe. There we go. Let's find some stone. Right here. And then right here. And I'm going to dig this in probably 3 deeper. We're not going to really have a wooden floor because it's not really necessary, but eventually we might. Because eventually when we get closer and closer, like around 90th house, I'm going to start building or start a new achievement. Well, think of one. Or you guys could send me a message of one or put a comment in the video where I announce I'm starting a new one soon. Which you'll know because essentially this is going to be a 100 episode series. Or actually a 99 episode series, because in this episode we're going to build two of the houses. So we've kind of got 99 episodes left, and I'm going to try and get as much of the recording of them done as soon as possible so I can get them out to you guys faster. But either way, yeah, we're almost done with this house. Question why I'm putting those on the third block up. Does make sense. There we go, this looks kinda nice. There's that. Let's get a stone sword, first priority. Because that's what we're going to need the most. A stone pick. Well, stone slabs we'll probably need too. Maybe. Well, that was kind of stupid of me. There we go. Now we have a stone pick, a stone shovel, and a stone sword along with it. A stone axe. So now we need to worry as much, but here's how we'll be able to tell my house apart from the rest is that just outside there's going to be blocks of cobblestone, 3 blocks high. Okay, so yeah, I think we're just gonna dig back in, start mining. Yeah, so this is where our mine's gonna be. We are gonna need some more coal when it starts to get dark. So, I will go and do that in the morning, but until then, this is what we're stuck with, so we'll just have to do this so we can see. Yeah, so actually I think we're gonna stop here with that mining, because that's pretty much as far down as we're gonna wanna go for now before mobs will start spawning, even though they probably will, and I realize now that we don't have a furnace. There's a skeleton just outside. I can hear him too. So, let's get ourselves another chest, just so we can have a double chest. And then we'll be ready to go for the night. Yeah, I'm not risking heading outside in the middle of the night, because of the fact that we're so far away from our home, and I've also got no armor, but maybe we could do this, is just leave all of our stuff here. Except our sword, so that way, in case we do die, like the second we step out there. Ow. Hey, skeleton, you need to die. You must die. You gotta die. There we go. But yeah, so there's some coal right up. This sheep is just asking to be killed. Not this sheep. Run, 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 run. About to die, about to die. Okay. That was perfect. So, let's go kill the sheep standing on the ledge who's asking to die. By standing on a ledge. Where did he go? Dang it. Oh well. Yeah. Let's get some food. And we only got... Yeah, we've only got 2 pieces of wool so far. So we're gonna need to go out and kill this sheep. So we can not have to worry about the situation again. And come out to a bunch of dead mob drops. Holy shit, they can do damage to dogs. I forgot about this. Yeah, that is eventually going to be an iron door. Oh yeah, then I should also make a hoe. So let's see, sticks. I'll make those beforehand. Then time for the bed. So that's the first priority we're going to go do in the morning, is go out, grab a bunch of seeds, and make a farm. Since we're also kind of near the ocean. Okay. So, wow. That went really fast. So, let's see. What else do we need? We need a pickaxe or axe or shovel. The extra wood and the saplings. So. Don't need these in my first slot. I'd rather have these. There we go. So, yeah. First priority, break a bunch of flowers. Shit, holy shit, holy shit. Back up. Jesus. I hate creeper explosions with turtle beaches on. Because it's just so freaking loud, and it causes so much lag for like a minute. You know what, I'm gonna just turn the music off. It just got loud and annoying. But yeah, so let's go for, there we go, 10 seeds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then I'll just break all the grass in near my house, just for the look appeal, and any seeds I get, I'll plant as well. Yeah, that's gonna be a priority as fast as we can, is to get that coal and mine up some more grass, but, or I'll dig up some more grass, I guess. But yeah, our top priority currently is food. Yeah, and the reason I'm deciding to plant all that down here is because this is where the sugarcane's gonna grow on the sand. Okay, so I'm trying not to ruin any of the crop, because, well, essentially that crop is our lifeline here. But there is some nice farming ground and house building ground around here. And if we need more sugarcane planting, there's some on over everywhere, pretty much. Yeah, so I think that's good enough with the farming over there. But now, what would be amazing is if we could get a zombie to drop a potato or a carrot. So that way we'll have just better food, first off, because they're much easier to farm, and we don't have to worry about, like, mining up, well, waiting until we have 3 hunger, because we're trying to preserve food, or 2 hunger, in our case currently, with the apples. Yeah, we're digging under very fragile ground. Oh, hey. Actually, let's skip to work on the second floor of our house, because we're going to want our house to be completely done. That's how tall it's gonna be, and yeah, we didn't get all the stone that we needed to out, but
Now, we're gonna have a walkway into our second floor. We're gonna definitely need some more wood for this project. So, but technically, I guess, no, it has to be individual houses. I was gonna say, what I was thinking, would it just have to be a single room that had a crafting bench? Then I realized it'd probably be more like a room if we were to, since we're 100%ing legit this challenge, we're not using any shortcuts whatsoever. Yeah, so let's go mine some more normal trees, and then I'll actually plant some saplings out here. Closer to the house though, so that way if we need more wood during the night while we're doing our mining. Oh Jesus, now it's starting to lag collecting wood. There we go, we got our stable FPS back. Yeah, that was pretty lucky our only resource that we really need in here is wood and iron. Because we're still going to want to get more technologically advanced. And by that I mean, the next challenge is going to have something to do with Tech It Classic. So we can't really, we're basically going to only use the classic stuff, like nether. Yeah, we're not going to the nether at all. We can't use TNT carts or carts with hoppers. We can't use heads. We can't use gold. Actually, that means we can't use potatoes and carrots. Well, were they in 1.4.7? I don't remember. But we can't use nether, quartz, beacons, I'm pretty sure, and hoppers. But I'll check out all the stuff that got removed later when we're kind of like done with this episode. I'll see if there's anything in Tech It with a 5.1.1, or if there's a buildcraft for 5.5.1, or if you guys could just tell me in the comments, that'd be useful. But yeah, that's probably what that's gonna be one thing that the next challenge has to do with, and that could be anything from linking all the chests into one central mainframe. But either way, all of that, it's gonna have to not do with building any more houses really, but more of building stuff with Tech It or Buildcraft, depending on it. But it could also be Tech It Lite if we need it, but that only depends if that is Buildcraft. I have not experimented at all with Tech It Lite. I prefer Tech It Classic by so much. Tech It Classic is just the best mod pack out of the Technic launcher. That is a guarantee. The Yogbox or /Mine is a close second, and then comes Volts, and behind that's Tech It Lite and everything else within it, like people's custom mod packs. Because people, I bet, are gonna just copy like tech it all over the place. Like they're literally just gonna take everything in the tech it and call it their own. And then they'll get, and they'll be dumbasses like that and probably get like sued and shit. And yeah, that's what's gonna happen with them adding the custom mod pack download feature into the Technic launcher. Let's remove all of this that's like just outside. Yeah, until something starts to creep up on me or hit me, depending on if I finish this, that's when I'll go inside. Well, yeah, actually, it's now the full night cycle, I can see the moon, so actually, let's just go inside now. So, nice, we got a stack of wood. That's going to be useful. It's going to be so freaking useful. That's almost unbelievable. Now, to store the stuff. The chest that we don't need. So, let's think. What don't we need? Bones, dirt, arrows, flour, coal we should probably keep on us. Birchwood for sticks, cobblestone, flint, gravel, all of this wood, a hoe, seeds. We'll keep our shovel on us too. Rotten flesh, sword, axe we won't need, and that cobblestone we won't need. So, yeah, this is really all we need, so let's set it up in appropriate order. Sword, pickaxe, torch, food, shovel, block, food, miscellaneous. Okay, so now at the very bottom of this hole, we're going to put a torch down. Wow, that is so much better. How useful? Literally, like, a few blocks deeper, we find iron. Just what we were looking for, too. So, let's see. We've got enough for a pickaxe. So, let's see. That's six. So, it's a pickaxe and a sword. Yeah, a pickaxe, a sword, and that's really all we need, besides armor, which, if we find any more iron, that's pretty much what it's going to go into. Other than probably like an iron hoe, that might be useful. But yeah, actually quartz would be nice, so we're just gonna go for some quartz, but I'm gonna save this world and make a copy of it before we go to the nether. And I'll use the copy as our nether world. Or as our 1.5.1 world that we can use 1.5.1 stuff. So, that's pretty much what the future episodes are going to entitle, and I won't really do much more exploring around in this world. I might just come on here and do like a bit of digging. If I find anything interesting, I'll start recording. Like if I found a cave or something. Actually, I'm gonna head up and I'm gonna start this smelting of iron, so that way we can use that. Okay, well, here we are. So, let's see. Furnace, that, one piece of coal, then we'll come back up when the pickaxe breaks. And that's what we'll use. Yeah, there's like mobs everywhere. I can hear them everywhere too. Nice, we're only down to 20 torches. And we started off with 24, so we've only used 4 torches, and we're at 35, so we're getting closer to diamond level. Once we hit 12 is when I'll probably start branch mining. So, but yeah, if we're already at like 30, that's pretty amazing how we only have 18 more layers to go. And you guys are wondering why I'm doing my computer's keyboard is kind of at an awkward position, so my arm needs to take a rest every once in a while. So let's see, our pickaxe broke. I'll put a torch here. We'll eat an apple, and then we'll head back up. Yeah, so one thing we're probably going to want to start doing is heading, if we can, is head to 000, because there's generally some weird stuff that happens at 00 of any altitude. Let's see, do I have any more sticks in here? Nope. Let's see, I'm gonna need to make a new set of sticks for this new pickaxe. Boom. There's the iron pick. There's the iron sword. So, I'll replace it. The stone sword's a backup. So let's also deposit this dirt. So like that's really ever gonna be useful. But so we're a decent ways down. So yeah. Yeah, so this is much more efficient speed wise and strength wise. I'm happy we found that iron. That was really lucky, but it's unlucky how that's the only iron we found. Oh, here's some more iron. Yeah. At level 13, too. That's just convenient. Boom that there, boom that there. Boom that there. I can hear lava boiling behind this ground. There's like lava above us or something. Nah, there's lava to the left of us. that would make sense why we're finding all these ores on the left side. Okay, here we are. Let's walk up to 10. There's some coal. We're also gonna wanna mine up all the coal that we can get. Also, because of this. Oh yeah, if you guys are wondering what I'm doing. I'm digging towards that lava. Well, I found some redstone. I can foresee that being helpful. See, how much iron did I collect? 10? That's gonna be enough. With the stack of coal, pretty much. Gold. I can find my way out of here. When I get upstairs and start the iron smelting, that is when we will end the video. So I figure that's an appropriate time, well, after we check on the crops, too. So we can probably turn F3 off now. See, yeah, this really does take a long time. Oh Jesus, it started lagging from all of the changes we've made to this world. Actually, Jesus, I'm getting low on health, and I didn't even realize it. Well, then again, I guess mining does really drain a lot out of you, especially when you're looking for some lava. Okay, well, yeah, so let's pop that in there, and then that in there. Then go in there. Go in there. Stay in there. Yeah, this is really all we should need, is these stacks of wood. So, let's go check on our farm. Looks like a tree grew. Let's hope it didn't affect our upstairs in any way. Looks like multiple of the trees grew. Well, either way. Yeah, so there might be some random points of lag for you guys, but that's just my computer, which can be slow at times. That's only when I've literally like had it on for a day or two, which is kind of reasonable. You guys have to agree with that. So this is pretty much going to be like our smelting hut. And in the meantime, I'm going to, since we've got the time, I'm literally just going to build one more room on top of this, because we've literally got all day to do this. Either way, I've still got, well, you know what, I think I'll count these rooms as houses. If they are a decent sized room, like this, is, this is livable in. Well, it's almost livable in. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Then I'm going to need 2 crafting benches in that case. So in that case, we've already got 2 of them done. And I plan on getting 3. Yeah, we ran out of birch wood, I guess, so time to use our massive stack of other wood. Yeah, in the meantime, guys, what I'm gonna do is mine down a bunch of the trees, so since it's nighttime, let's go get a rest. And then I'll build the other house, then end the video. Yeah. So, yeah, there is going to vary from anywhere from 97 episodes now. Oh, actually, yeah, 98 episodes, as I think of it. Yeah, anywhere from 98 down to probably like 5. So, yep. Actually, let's check on our iron, and we'll make ourselves an iron axe. That is something that would be useful. It's an iron axe. Along with a pair of shears. That's what we need. Oh, yeah, that's right. We'll need flint and steel for the nether eventually. So, let's see. Boom, boom. Add these to here. No, add them to here. That. That. Hold on, we got an iron axe, shears. Do I have it the other way around? Flint and steel. Let's put our flint and steel in the chest. And I just heard a really weird noise. Like, it was like a gust of creepy air. It might have just been my computer or something. Or like a sound effect from another game that I was hearing, but oh well, let's go forth, finisheth the houseth, and hith, we shalleth, not this, and remaineth. God, Minecraft has some weird sounds now. Yeah, hopefully that Enderman doesn't come up behind me and butt hump me. Because if he does, I'm going to be very angry at him. Yeah, like, we can make this livable in. I mean, it'll have a trapdoor entrance, probably, but actually that'd be kind of cool. Have a, or nah, it can have a door. Because I need to make these walls 4 high anyway, so they're already 1 high now, most of them anyway. But since these blocks aren't so yeah, there's going to be a nice little hallway which will lead to the entrance. And yeah, then we'll be done with this episode, and we can all say that we have accomplished something. But this will probably be coming out on the let me check, the 5th or late at night if you live in like the general mountain time zone. Yeah, if you live in mountain time, for like if you live in primarily Colorado, and I think parts of Kansas, Oklahoma, Montana, and Wyoming, parts of there mainly, is where you're gonna find this time zone. So it's mainly more along the Rockies, since literally from where I live I can see the Rockies by looking out the window. So, and I don't mean the baseball team, I mean the actual legit Rocky Mountains. But yeah, nice. We got a stack of wood left, and that will be just enough. This is not gonna. One. Whoops. One. That's. I'm gonna just put a torch over in this corner area on this wall. So, here we go. But, here's what for us defines a, here's what for us is going to define a completed building. Is a building with four walls, or more, I guess. Or actually, two or three walls or more. So, almost done. Then, I think I decided I was gonna put the entrance in this wall. And then, oh, okay. Oops. I guess the lag stopped a little while ago, and I just didn't notice I was concentrating on watching TV, but, oh well. So, Yeah, this episode's almost done. So, that's why I was standing there idly for like, probably like 5 minutes. Was both the combination of lag and TV. But, yeah, so we've completed 3 houses. And we're ready to go. So, we'll see y'all next time in episode 3. And I will have, or in episode 2, I don't know why I said 3, but I will have tons of wood and food, is my plan. So I'm going to go out, kill a bunch of pigs and stuff, kill a bunch of cows, probably not kill some chickens, because I want their eggs, but if I do find any eggs, then I'll collect them, and I'll probably also have some, like, diamonds, anything, but I'll probably won't be mining here. I'll probably, like, go so far away that I'm not even gonna bother to make the trip anymore, just because that's where I'll generally find diamonds, is the furthest away from home, or if I find the end portal, that would be weird. But, yeah, so I'll see y'all later with a bunch of materials and stuff, and goodbye.
Ha ha ha!